which... William, is a remarkable bacterium because...
It's the only known organism that lives in sulfuric acid.
That's right, and... Yes, Miss Ronnie?
Deinococcus radiodurans, first discovered in 1956, spreading its diatoms of radioactive waste.
That's correct. So, Papa John, Thiobacillus, Deinococcus, which of these three would most likely survive in the extreme environment of the Jupiter moon Callisto, and why? Tom, can you get the lights, please? That's your lab report question for this week, and it's due in my box by midnight on Friday. That's all for today. Thank you.
So, are you coming to the faculty conference tonight?
Off lecture about how the universe is like a beautiful world. I think I'll pass.
Come on. It'll be fun. I can pick you up.
Can't. Have to get back to my own extreme environment. But thank you.
See you, Mom.
Yeah.
If you'll come with us.
What's happening?
Everything will be explained, but you must come with us right away.
Am I under arrest?
You're in federal custody.
Why? What is this about?
Everything will be explained en route.
I have a child here.
Is there anyone who can look after the boy?
No.
Can his father take care of
him? No, his father isn't here. I can take care of myself. Jacob, you can't take care of yourself. There's just no
way.
You're
coming with us, Dr. Benson.
Helen?
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Yusuf.
Hello.
Helen, do you have any idea why this is happening to us?
No.
Not a thing. What do we have in common?
What do you do for a living, Yusuf?
I'm a nuclear physicist.
I'm an astronomer.
I'm a geologist.
I'm an astrobiologist.
Fossil record study.
No, microbiology. Theories of life.
All right, so we're all scientists.
Yeah, I'm not me. I'm a civil engineer.
Put it all together, what do you get?
I participated in government mobilizations like this before. War games and preparations for certain scenarios.
I think this is.
No, whatever it is, it's not a game.
Object 07/493 was first spotted just beyond Jupiter's orbit by the Space Guard program. It was notable for the fact that it was not moving in an asteroidal ellipse, but rather it had a hyperbolic orbit and was shooting through our solar system. The object was moving at speeds of up to 3 × 10⁷ meters per second. At first, it was projected to pass millions of miles outside of Earth's orbit. However, we soon discovered that the object was not following a gravitationally free-fall trajectory. As such, its path was recalculated. At this time, the crisis response team was activated and everything you see around you was set in motion.
Can we launch a missile to intercept it?
The military is attempting to do just that. In fact, they may launch several, but given the speed which this object is moving, our chances of success are slim at best.
Why don't they evacuate the area?
We simply do not have enough time. The affected area contains some 8 million inhabitants. The best we can do is to plan for the aftermath.
How long do we have?
78 minutes.
Hey, where did the cops went anyway?
Well,
it will sterilize the air. This is all theater.
They're saying we lost launch capability.
The missile's disabled.
Disabled by what?
We don't know.
But they gave it a start, right? There's a fallback. They have to launch.
Object impact in 7. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One.
What is it?
They've made a mistake.
Wait. Roger that. They're saying the object's still in its approach.
Well, then where is it?
Slowing down. Slow down.
I see it.
Radiation levels are slightly elevated, but it's not dangerous.
I'm getting a lot of electrostatic interference.
Yeah, me too. Did you feel that? Feel what?
I feel it. It's close.
Checkmate 06, you must have to move land here.
06, this is 2917. I need to know who has jurisdiction on the site.
Thank you.
do? Let's blood is red. It looks like hemoglobin.
Okay, I can't find a vein. It doesn't have any veins.
Look for a central line site then.
Going into cardiac arrest, Ethan.
Yeah, get into town.
Ethan, now. Fire!
And chop her to a genomics lab for DNA mapping.
I'd like a sample of that as well.
I am entering the wound. And my God. What is this? I'm sorry. I'm a little taken aback.
What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. That's the thing. It's all so familiar. The outer layer of the flesh is exotic. It's strange, but as I go deeper, it's muscle, vein.
MRI like Times Square.
Get help.
The old white subject is conscious.
Vital intelligence on that mainframe. They know everything about us now.
Well,
We know nothing about them.
Almost nothing. The fact that they chose to disable our defenses tells us something about their intentions.
Madam Secretary, we brought in several specialists to analyze the tissue samples from Harmston from the VA. This is our chief geneticist, Dr. Hideo Ikigawa. This is our chief astrobiologist, Dr. Hobbins. Doctor.
The being is in a nascent state. The DNA samples we've taken seem to represent three distinct life forms.
Three different DNA types?
Yes, including the being's brain. The body tissue is human, as far as we can tell. The gray flesh encasing it is organic material, some kind of bioengineered spacesuit. What it resembles, oddly enough, is placental tissue.
Which makes sense, given that placenta is a life support system. And that basically, in order to survive in our environment, the being had to be born here, in its human form. They must have come here in the past and obtained a DNA sample from a human subject. Now, since that birth, the being has grown exponentially. This is 1 hour after surgery. 3 hours. 6 hours. How much can you tell us about it by decoding its DNA?
You don't understand. These are the Dead Sea Scrolls. Geneticists are going to be studying this code for generations.
No, they aren't. This code is the property of the U.S. government. Its very existence is classified. I want to see it. Is Regina Jackson. I'm the Secretary of Defense of the United States of America.
This body will take some getting used to.
I've been sent here to determine who or what you represent and what your intentions are.
It feels unreal to me.
Represent a civilization?
I represent a group of civilizations.
Where is this group of civilizations?
All around you.
What is your purpose in coming here?
There is a gathering of world leaders not far from here. I will explain my purpose to them.
I'm afraid that's not possible. Perhaps you should explain yourself to me instead.
Do you speak for the entire human race?
I speak for the President of the United States. Now please, tell me, why have you come to our planet?
Your planet?
Yes, this is our planet.
No, it is not.
We've decided to sedate him and move him to a more secure location.
Are you going to interrogate him?
That's a possibility.
Madam Secretary, as scientists, we can't consent to this.
He says he wants to speak to the UN.
History has lessons to teach us about first encounters between civilizations. As a rule, the less advanced civilization is either exterminated or enslaved. I'm thinking of Pizarro and the Incas, Columbus and the Native Americans. The list goes on. Unfortunately, in this case, the less advanced civilization is us.
This is representative of an extraterrestrial civilization. This is the most important discovery in the history of mankind.
It may well be the last discovery in the history of mankind. We need to know what they're planning, and we need to know now.
So you want
to
drug him? Interrogate him? I'm sorry, we won't do that. You understand?
I understand completely. Of course, if you won't do it, we'll have to call in someone who will.
Well, I'm sure you can find someone who will.
I'll do it. apologize to you. Seems we got off to a bad start.
It seems we did.
We're going to transport you to a different facility for better medical care.
No, you're not.
Excuse me?
I am leaving.
I can't allow you to do that.
It is not up to you.
This is a military installation. You're surrounded by hundreds of soldiers. There's no leaving here.
I have done nothing wrong.
You invaded our airspace. That automaton that emerged from the sphere, it attacked our troops.
It acted to defend me. It activates in the presence of violence.
Dr. Benson, please.
Ma'am.
law enforcement, federal, state, and local on high alert.
The media gets word that we
use a cover story. We can't risk a panic. Call him an escaped convict. Use every surveillance satellite, every drone aircraft, every freeway camera. Use every resource we've got.
Thank you.
Secretary. They're sending in the drones.
Bring in the Reapers! We have go!
Roger that! Descending the 1200! Here, let's light this thing up.
Thank you. silence, no aggressive actions, no matter what happens, no gunfire.
Track is in place, sir. Containment panels are in position. We're ready on your order.
On my command. Move the panels into place.
Three.
It's us. Those were ordinary cephalopods. Squid, talk to me.
like him and he wants to move in.
No, it's not like that. God, no. Listen to me. No one is moving in. You don't understand.
Whatever, you wait for him. I'm going home.
Check.
Back to the city.
Now, can you tell me what's going on?
Did you do that?
Yes.
Jacob, get in the car.
He's one of them.
Please get in the car.
Get in the car.
I need to know what's happening.
This planet is dying. The human race is killing it.
So you've come here to help us?
No, I didn't.
You said you came to save us.
I said I came to save the Earth.
You came to save the Earth? From us. You came to save the Earth from us.
We can't risk the survival of this planet for the sake of one species.
What are you saying?
If the Earth dies, you die. If you die, the Earth survives. There are only a handful of planets in the cosmos that are capable of supporting complex life.
You can't do this.
This one can't be allowed to perish.
We could change. We could still turn things around.
We've watched, we've waited, and hoped that you would change.
Please.
It's reached the tipping point. We have to act.
Please.
Undo the damage you've done and give the Earth a chance to begin again.
Don't do this. Please. We could change. We can change.
Decision is made. The process has begun.
Oh, God.
Child in the car?
Yes.
This is HP-28. I'm an I-67. I have the FBI suspect in custody, along with one adult female and one child, awaiting instructions. Tell the child to get out of the car. Get the kid out of the car! Okay, you two, over there. You, I'm not gonna tell you again. Hands on the car.
Please don't hurt him.
Not gonna hurt him, so long as he's...
I'm talking to you.
The pain will only last a moment.
You
obstacle. I meant him no harm.
You could stop this, couldn't you? If you wanted to.
I tried to reason with you. I tried to speak with your leaders.
Those aren't our leaders. If you want to speak to one of our leaders, I'll take you to one. Let me take you.
Specimens from our planet.
It's not our planet. That's what he said to me in the hospital. An ark. It's an ark. So are all the other spheres. They're saving as many species as they can.
If the sphere is an ark, then what comes next is...
the flood. He won it for his work in biological altruism. Probably still be in his desk drawer if I hadn't gotten it framed for him.
It's beautiful.
So we're not so different after all.
I wish that were true.
So is it a machine or a living thing?
It's both. Or neither.
What do you mean, neither?
It seems to be some sort of silicone-based hybrid. I'm calling it GORT, genetically organized robotic technology.
Military and their acronyms.
Used every diagnostic method available, MRI, thermal imaging, PET scan. I was impervious. So we attempted to robotically assist in exploration using a diamond drill here. The drill bit fractured in like 24 hours to fix it robotically.
Thank you.
atmosphere.
Amidst the chaos in the New York, New Jersey areas, local police are looking for an escaped convict whose name is not being released. Authorities believe that he is a significant threat to the public and are asking for any information that could lead to his capture. If you've seen this man, please contact the number on your screen below.
There must be alternatives. You must have some technology that could solve our problem.
Your problem is not technology. The problem is you. You lack the will to change.
Then help us change. I cannot change your nature. You treat the world as you treat each other. But every civilization reaches a crisis point eventually.
Most of them don't make it.
Yours did.
How? Our sun was dying. We had to evolve in order to survive.
So it was only when you were threatened with destruction that you became what you are now.
Yes.
Well, that's where we are. You say we're on the brink of destruction, and you're right. But it's only on the brink that people find the will to change. Only at the precipice do we evolve. This is our moment. Don't take it from us. We're close to an answer.
Take out the target. Roger that.
leave. I don't know that he will. But I think he trusts me. And I don't think he wants to do this.
We have the situation under control. Madam Secretary, General Quinn needs to see you in the briefing room. He says it's urgent.
You're not in control.
You don't know what he's capable of.
But she didn't do anything wrong. So they should let her go, right?
You're afraid you're going to be left alone.
I already am alone. Helen's just someone that was stuck with me when my dad died, you know? Oh, I forgot. You're an alien. You don't understand anything.
We're good to go.
Answer to the president. You're on your own.
No, she's not. I'll go with you.
understand the situation. But with all due respect, sir, any further military action will only make things worse. I believe we may still be able to open a dialogue. Yes, Mr. President. As you wish, sir. Thank you.
Roger that.
You're slowing down.
Letting us through.